Ben Stark here, recording a draft video for channelfireball.com. We're doing a Kaladesh, a single elimination draft league. Let's see what we have here. We opened Deepala. It's a pretty good rare, but it is gold. Furious Reprisal, not a card I like a lot. I mean, I would always play it. You know, you can take it first, but I think that's not really great. It's more of like a third to fifth pick. Always makes your main, but not exceptional. Thriving Rhino, I think, is the best green common, and I think green is the best color. But I think green is the best color because of how deep it is, how many good commons there are, not because Thriving Rhino is just amazing or anything, but it is a strong card. So this is a pretty weak pack overall. I think basically we're just deciding between Thriving Rhino and Deepala. There's nothing else I would really consider. I think Thriving Rhino is better than Reprisal, not by a lot, but I think it's better. And it's the best color, and red's probably the worst color. Think we should go with Deepala. I think it's powerful enough that if we end up red-white, we'll have a Deepala, and if we have to go elsewhere, then we'll drop the Deepala. It's no big deal. Plenty of playables in Kaladesh. Okay, pick two. Voltaic Brawler's good, but not the same colors as Deepala. Veteran Motorist would have been a little better. Attune is nice. Tiger is nice. Oh, Welding Sparks. Well, that's the best red common, and certainly an easy pick here. It's probably the best card in the pack, and it's the same color as our first pick rare. So, not too much of a dilemma here. Thriving Turtle's okay, but I find it a little underpowered, unless you're really producing a lot of energy, like a blue-green energy control deck with attunes and things like that. Inspired Charge is a good card if you end up going wide, but certainly not something we're considering over Welding Sparks pick two. So pretty easy pick here. Okay, this is going to be a little bit tougher. Glimmer's a good card. Nothing amazing, but pretty good. Peafowl also. There's not really a single red or white card that we want in this pack. Eddie Trailhawk is maybe moderately playable, but it's like not something you even hope makes your main. Definitely not something you want to be third picking. Peafowl is pretty solid. High Spire Artisan's okay if you're a defensive green deck. Malphus Squad is good in a black-red artifacts or a black-white go-wide deck. So, I mean, Malphus Squad is good, basically, in almost any black deck. At this point, with no red or white cards in the pack, we basically just have to decide between Glimmer, because I think that's the best card in the pack, or Malphus Squad, because it goes better with Welding Sparks, I think, than Glimmer. I think blue-red is really just not a deck. I think at this point, though, you can easily splash Welding Sparks into like a or Glimmer into some kind of three-color artifact deck. So I think we'll take Glimmer because I think it's the best card in the pack by a lot. And if we ended up green-blue, we can splash Welding Sparks. If we end up, you know, any combination of black-blue or black-red, we can splash the Sparks or the Glimmer. Okay, so pick four. Servant is pretty good. Aether Meltdown is pretty good. Revoke Privileges, if we want to look back at Deepala and white. I mean, Revoke Privileges is good. I consider it the second best white common after Glintsleeve Artisan. I know more people probably favor Revoke because it's removal, but sometimes it doesn't work out that good if your opponent has a mechanic or that 3-mana card that exiles a creature and puts it back into play. Plus, there's like Fragmatize and Appetite. There's a lot of things that can punish an enchantment. It's still a good card. I would still always play it, but I tend to take the Glintsleeve Artisans over it. Here, though, it's a close pick. I guess we have to assume we probably are seeing white if we got a fourth pick Revoke, and I think Revoke is only slightly worse, if it's even worse, than the Servant or the Meltdown. I think it is worse, but only by a little bit, so considering it could let us play Deepala, I think that we should take it. I would not have took a bad white card there to try and play Deepala. I would just move off Deepala. But when you're looking at one of the best white commons fourth, it's not necessarily a sign, like we don't know what's open or not, but it's a card that we should take because it's one of the best white commons, it's their fourth, and we have a red, white, gold rare. Okay, so now Inventor's Apprentice is pretty good if you end up a nice red, white aggro deck. Build to Smash, also pretty good in that deck. Spontaneous Artist is fine, like, it's a solid card, nothing special. Those are basically the only cards I would even consider here. I think I'm going to take Inventor's Apprentice. It's possible Built to Smash is better, but Inventor's Apprentice this early will allow me to prioritize like artifacts and being really aggressive. And I should have the opportunity to pick up Built to Smashes later. Okay, so it seems pretty clear we are seeing white, so let's assume we're going to be able to play a red-white deck. Now we see three different white commons, all of which I would play. Mechanic, Charge, and Bridge Patrol. Unruly Mob wasn't good in previous formats, but Bridge Patrol is just good in this format. There's a lot of trading on the ground, extra creatures from Fabricate, and if stuff gets bounced or you bounce your own stuff, the Bridge Patrol grows. So it's a lot easier to get it going in the first place than it was Unruly Mobs in previous formats. Okay, so this is a close pick. I don't think you'd really go wrong taking any of these cards, but I think this early I'm going to take Inspired Charge. When you pick up Inspire Charge early, you know you can then draft a lot of servo making and you know, a lot of really aggressive stuff. So none of those cards were amazing. I think the mechanic and the charge were really close there, but I think this early in a draft it makes sense to secure the charge, since now you know you have one, you can probably get a second and you can draft accordingly. This pack is pretty bad. Subtle Strike is like a kind of playable trick. Reckless Fireweaver is pretty bad, although if we're prioritizing artifacts, maybe we'll play it. Peafowl's good, but I mean, I think we have a red-white deck. I don't really see a blue deck coming together here. So I guess just in case we see nothing but blue, I'll take the Peafowl, because I don't think I'll ever miss the Fireweaver, but I'm hoping to not play it. Okay, and second Inspire Charge early is fine. Like, this is a powerful card. At the moment, we only have two creatures, so we're hoping that the rest of the draft we have no trouble picking up lots of servo-making creatures, and it's still very early. It looks like, you know, we probably are seeing blue also, but none of these blue cards are particularly good. So, I mean, this is a pretty clear pick, and we'll see what comes. Spireside Infiltrator is a fine creature. Nothing special. We're not looking to draft creatures that cost four or more mana unless they're really special, given the double charge, and we're looking to be a really aggressive deck. Spireside Infiltrator fits our deck nicely. It's a pretty clear pick there. So third Inspired Charge. I don't know how many of them we will end up playing. It really depends on how much servo making we can get and how wide we can go. I'm going to clearly take it here because there's no other cards in our color. Consulate Surveillance is not playable in a deck like this. Probably not in any deck, but definitely not in a deck like this. I don't necessarily know if we'll get to play all of our Inspired Charges or not. That depends on how the rest of the draft goes. These cards aren't really playable, don't really matter. Let's see what Pack 2 is going to have for us. Some potential good cards we could open. Really all we need, though, at this point, is Servo Making, the Glintsleeve Artisan, the Propeller Pioneer, the ability to go wide, cheaply, and aggressively. The 2-mana uncommon that makes 2 servos would be quite good in our deck. I would play White Puzzle Knots. Okay, so Key to the City is pretty good. There's Servo Expedition. That's the white uncommon I was talking about. This is a good pack. A lot of cards that we could consider taking, and nothing that really stands out, I don't think. Key to the City is pretty good, but it's not necessarily something we need. We're going to try and go wide, probably. Bazaar Barge is a good card. Nothing special. The Servo Expedition is a good card in our deck. The Propeller Pioneer. This is an interesting spot. With 3 Inspired Charges already, I feel like maybe I should be taking Servo Expedition here, though I really think in general Key to the City is considerably higher power level, along with Bomet Bazaar Barge also being higher power level. But yeah, I think at this point we should be trying to draft like a 16 land, go as wide as we can, super aggressive deck. So I think we're going to take the Servo Expedition on that plan. And we're rewarded Toolcraft Exemplar. So we almost have a standard deck going with Inventor's Apprentice and Toolcraft Exemplar and Dipala. We're not going to get all standard playable cards, but we are going to try and make a very aggressive red-white deck. Okay, so Aerial Responder is a little bit off-theme compared to Eager Construct, but I don't think we're willing to go that far in terms of sacrificing power. It's still a 3-drop. It's cheap. It's just a great card. So I think we'll take Aerial Responder. It's not nearly as broken as people who played with Vampire Nighthawk and some of those formats might remember that card being, even though it looks similar. But it's a nice creature. It's cheap. It's efficient. It's tough for the opponent to block. It's tough for the opponent to race. Though I will play any number of Eager Constructs we pick up in this deck, because it's an artifact and it has pretty good positive synergy, I'm not going to take it over Aerial Responder, not just yet. Our curve is not amazing, but it's not that bad. So here I am going to take Thriving Grubs over Consul's Shield Guard for curve reasons, and in terms of power, I don't think they're that different anyway. The Thriving Grubs is just an okay, cheap, aggressive 2-drop that we can play. It's not really competing with much else. There's a Gearsmith, which is a great card, but I'm not really looking to splash in our 16-land aggro deck that we're drafting. Another Inventor's Apprentice. So we have the potential to draft a really good, really aggressive deck, but we do need more artifacts. They're not usually that hard to get in this color combination. Just haven't really seen much of it. But hopefully we can start getting some of those Servo Makers. I mean, right now, the only artifact in our entire deck is the Servo Expedition. It makes 2 artifacts. But, I mean, there are a lot of cards that that do that, so hopefully we can get some Propeller Pioneers, some Glint Sleeve Artisans, some Eager Constructs. The White Puzzle Knot is fine in this deck. Sky Skiff would be excellent. Just any cheap artifacts, or cheap artifact making. With what we have now, there's no way I would play Acrobatic Maneuver. But if we do pick up a lot of those cards, which we will be prioritizing, we would. And otherwise, there's just Eddy Trail Hawk and Pressure Point, which I don't think are offering us anything. Plus, you never know. Maybe your opponent will have double Malfunction, and this will just be a good sideboard card or something. Okay, well, that's good artifact making. A second Servo Expedition. And it's not that shocking for it to go that late, because even though it's a card we really want, a lot of decks don't really care about it. There are even a lot of white decks that maybe would play it, maybe wouldn't. It's just incredibly powerful in our deck with triple Inspired Charge and 3 uncommon and rare 1-drops that need an artifact in play. So that's a good pickup for us. I would say our deck is positioned to end up being really good and really broken, but it needs to come together. We need to get some Sky Skiffs, some Glint Sleeve Artisans. We just need cheap artifacts, and this deck will be really good. But we're not seeing it. Gearseeker Serpent is great. Not something we're looking to do, but a great card. Blue is really controlling in this format, and it's just a great win condition. It's usually 5 mana, sometimes 6. It blocks really well the turn you play it, and then it can always win the game in a stalemate or just by attacking. For us, I guess it's going to be Reckless Fireweaver number 2. Herald is not something we're particularly interested in. If we do pick up a lot of artifacts or things that can use one power creature like Sky Skiffs, we could definitely play Fireweaver. Every Servo Expedition will deal 2, and we're going to be prioritizing those type of cards. Along those lines, there's a Propeller Pioneer. This is a pretty clear pick. Salivating Gremlins could be good if we ended up with a lot of artifacts, but we need the artifacts right now. So Propeller Pioneer being 2 bodies for Inspired Charge plus making a Servo is a no-brainer, even though I don't want to take too many 4-mana cards. I really like 2 and 3-mana creatures a lot more than 4-mana creatures at this point. Neither of these red and white cards are going to make our main. I'm not a huge fan of Impeccable Timing, but if it happens to line up well with what the opponent has, it could certainly be a card I would sideboard in. Hijack 2, but it's double red and a little more expensive, so I think the timing is the pick. There's a Puzzle Knot. That's actually quite a good card in our deck. It's not a great card. It's worse than Servo Expedition, but we want to go wide. We need the artifact that'll sit in play. So I think that card is almost certainly going to make our deck. And we can justify pretty much any card that makes 2 creatures once you have 3 Inspired Charges and a curve this low. Okay, these cards are not playable. So 16 playables on the pack 3. Potentially a really high power level. We just need to flesh out our deck now. Sky Skiff would be excellent. I would love to pick up 1 or 2 of those this pack. Glint Sleeve Artisan would be excellent. I would love to pick up 1 or 2 of those this pack. Of course, also any good removal. Harness Lightning, Welding Sparks. Pyro Helix I'm a lot less big on than the other 2 removal spells I just named, but I would still certainly play it. It's too bad we're not green. Long Tusk Cub, the mythic uncommon of this set. It's near unbeatable. So this pick for us is going to be between Propeller Pioneer, Weldfast Monitor, and Inspiring Vantage. And I actually think the Inspiring Vantage might be right. When you're playing a hyper aggro deck, a dual land that good is pretty strong, because I only want to run 16 lands, and if I really get enough 2s and 1s and have that Vantage, I might consider 15. And having the extra source of both untapped all the time is really good. That said, Pioneer, Weldfast Monitor, probably better cards. But with already 16 playables, I kind of feel like, and we could play some Reckless Fireweavers if we wanted to, I really feel like the land might offer more to our deck than one of the commons. I would never take Inspiring Vantage over Propeller Pioneer like early in a draft. But now that I have such a focused aggressive deck with such a low curve, I think I'm actually going to take it. I promise I'm not rare drafting here. It's probably worth a half a tick. Okay, so this is another pack with a lot of cards that we would play, which is good because maybe we'll table one of them. Veteran Motorist is a pretty clear pick here, I think. It's a really cheap aggressive body, and the Scry 2 is really nice for smoothing out your draws. But if I could just take this pack and not draft the rest of the pack, I probably would. We would probably play like the whole pack, like Avery Mechanic, Built to Smash, Glintsleeve Artisan, and Propeller Pioneer, which is really good because hopefully we'll table one. Fabrication Module can be really good, but I don't think it's going to be in our deck. We don't really make energy or use energy. So I think for us, this is a pretty clear Veteran Motorist, even though I keep talking about needing to get artifacts. And even though it's not an artifact on turn two, it does scry two, so it helps you find the cards you actually need. And not flooding out is one of the most important things for a deck like this. So I really like what the Motorist offers. Okay, I didn't expect to see a second Inspiring Vantage. On the one hand, that could let us get to 15 lands, I think, because then we could have plenty of sources of both red and white. On the other hand, we still need playables. Part of why I like taking lands aggressively once you know you have enough playables is because you get value out of your land slot, and your 23rd, 24th, 25th playable will probably be good enough anyway. But now that, you know, we already took one land, it's kind of tough to keep taking them. There's Pyro Helix and Brazen Scourge, which are both pretty good for our deck. Nothing amazing. Both will definitely make our deck. So I don't think we're going to take the second Vantage. Although it would be sweet, I think, at this point now. We only have 17. We still are hoping to get, like, another 7 playables. So I don't think it's correct to take second Vantage. I think this time we should probably go with Pyro Helix or Brazen Scourge. Probably Pyro Helix. Even though I don't love the card, it's cheap. You know, we might be stuck on two sometimes because we're going to play 16 lands. So I think we should take that. Captured by the Consulate is not really a playable in an aggro deck since the creature can still block. It's a good card if somehow you're control in white, which white usually isn't, but maybe a light splash into a blue-green deck or something like that, or just a white-blue control deck. So there's only one card in this pack, Ninth Bridge Patrol, that I think we'll play. I don't think it's amazing in our deck, but I think we'll play it. And Captured, I guess, could be a sideboard card, but I really can't see us using that card. Okay, so chance to pick up an artifact. Fragmentize is decent, but I think like we're right on pace, but we can't really take off picks for sideboard cards right now. Plus, I think we need artifacts, and I think Dragster and Inventor's Goggles are both fine in our deck. We have a lot of cheap creatures that would really love to have a Goggles in play. These are both Artificers. That's an Artificer. All three of those are, plus the Servos. They're not Artificers, but, you know, they're cheap, and it's not that hard to equip and turn your 1-1s into real creatures. So I think the Goggles would be pretty good for us. I think the Dragster is also reasonably good for us. We can give it +1/+1 with the Motorist. We're going to have plenty of 1-1s out to maybe crew it with. So I think this is a fairly close pick. I think I'm going to take the Dragster. It's a pretty powerful card. Our curve is pretty good. But I definitely would like a Goggles. I would definitely play a Goggles in this deck. Okay, well, now we have no choice but to take a Fragmentize because there's really no other cards in this pack I would play. So I don't really like Giant Spectacle. Ruinous Gremlin, sometimes you sideboard it in. Fragmentize is way more efficient at killing creatures. And you can main a Fragmentize. I'm hoping not to, but you definitely can. Whirler Virtuoso this late is pretty incredible. The card is very easy to splash and very good. We're not going to be able to splash it. That's just not what our deck is looking to do. but it's a great card. For us, there's really just only Ninth Bridge Patrol as a playable again. It's not the best in our deck since we really aren't that good at blinking. We don't have any mechanics. We have the one maneuver in the sideboard, which maybe I'll play now that we have double Bridge Patrol, but it's not amazing in our deck. Okay, this Visionary Augmenter is really good in our deck. I'm not excited about the fact that it costs 4. I think I'd rather just have a Glintsleeve Artisan, but it is a really good card. It makes 2 artifacts, 3 bodies for 1 creature. It's a really impressive card for this archetype. And if nothing else, I might just cut 1 Inspire Charge and play 2 and not 3. Nothing here that I would even consider playing. I'll take the Wayward Giant, just in case I want to board it in for some reason, but I can't imagine playing it. Oh, I think this is the pack I was hoping to table something out of, so it's kind of disappointing that we didn't. Although Spark of Creativity is actually better than it looks. I think it was Sam Black who referred to it as the Red Ponder, in the sense that you can't look at it as a good removal spell, but you can just look at it as a card that is, it's just good for what you pay for it. You pay 1 mana and you get a little bit more than 1 mana's worth out of it. And there's the Puzzle Knot, which is an artifact, but most likely not that great in our deck. I think I'm going to take the Puzzle Knot, because I think we need the artifact. Even though Red Puzzle Knot's not a great card to main deck, I think we are going to main it. It's very important that we have an early artifact with our 3-1 drops. But I think Spark would be a fine card too, you know? It's not like we have any 1-mana combat tricks that you just can't play or don't want to play. You know, let me grab this Gremlin. I'll talk a little bit more about Spark. So these cards don't matter, of course. Although I think we will play this Torch also, because I think we need the artifact. So with Spark, what you generally do is you don't want to play it on, turn 2 or 3. You want to play it on, turn 3, through 5, let's say. You can play it on 3, but you don't really want to. You want to play it on, turn 4 or turn 5. You play it before you play a land, right, on one of their decent creatures, but nothing too crazy, like a 3 toughness or 4 toughness creature. If you hit, then you get to have a positive tempo turn where you killed their 4 drop, let's say, for 1 mana. If you miss, you just play the land if you hit a land, or you just cast the card if it's like a 2 drop. So you basically can never whiff in the sense that you go down a card or anything like that, as long as you don't have Built to Smash or something that you can't play. Or, of course, even if you have other combat tricks, maybe you could play them, but that's not really, that's going down a card, you know. You would never play 1 mana deal 2 to the opponent or something like that. But if you don't have stuff like that, then if you hit an expensive card that you can't cast, you kill their creature that you targeted. And if you hit a cheap card that doesn't kill their creature, you just cast it. So the card is actually pretty flexible and pretty good. And I would normally take it over Fireforge's Puzzle Knot. I just felt like, given exactly what we have and what our deck does, we really wanted that cheap artifact. Because as you can see, we don't have a ton of artifacts. I mean, we have more than it looks like, because, of course, Visionary Augmenter makes 2. Servo Expeditions both make 2. And Propeller Pioneer makes 1. So it's not like we don't have artifacts, but I think we're going to play probably exactly what's laid out here, in which case we have 3 artifacts. I'm going to count these as 1, not 2, because for the purpose of drawing an artifact card, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cards that are an artifact or make an artifact. So that's enough. Not exceptional, not exciting. Our deck would be a lot better had we picked up a Glintsleeve Artisan or 2 and a Skyskiff or 2. I mean, we really only saw the Artisans early. Maybe the Vantage pick was a little greedy. I kind of thought we had plenty of time to get stuff and we might table stuff. And I really did like the fact that Vantage would give me red or white turn 1 and allow me to have at least 8, if not 9, of both of those on 16 land. You know, obviously on 16 you have 8-8, so now I have 9-8. So I felt like that was pretty valuable. But in hindsight, with exactly what we got, I do regret that pick. I would rather turn that into a Glintsleeve Artisan. We're going to play 1 Torch Gauntlet. We're not going to play 2. Card's not very good, but we do have a lot of 1-1s. I think it offers us a little bit. I don't really want to play 3 Inspire Charges. I kind of want to play 2. But the only other card I could really see playing are Fragmentize or Acrobatic Maneuver. Both of those are fine in our deck. I don't think we're going to play Reckless Fireweaver. I think that card is mostly good if you have a lot of artifacts, or if you can be crewing with it, but we only have 1 card to crew with it, and it's a 4-mana card that doesn't stick around that long. So it's not like a Skyskiff where turn after turn you could be hitting them for 2. Dragster tends to kill something and deal a few points of trample, but usually dies. So the only question, I think, for this deck is whether we want to cut 3rd Inspired Charge for Fragmentize or Acrobatic Maneuver. if we maneuver something, our ninth bridge patrol grows. That's nice, but not enough of a reason to run it. We can get a scry 2 out of the motorist. We can make a guy with pioneer or two guys with augmenter. I think it's going to be a sideboard card for us. I think that we should just run it like this, probably, with all three charges. And then if the charges aren't great in the matchup, we can board them out for Fragmentize if it's good, Maneuver if it's good, or Timing if it's good. But I think this is the correct main to run. And I would never run a mana base this spread apart. Magic Online often suggests things like this, and I almost always bring them together. If it thinks we should have more white than red, then we should probably have more white than red. But it should almost certainly be 8 plains, 7 mountains, not 10 plains, 5 mountains. I assume they do it mostly just by counting up your mana symbols. But the thing is, when you have a 2-color aggro deck like this, you have to have both red and white right away to win the game. So you just don't split like 10-5. You just split one in favor of the color that you have more of, generally. Once in a while, too. But even that I find pretty rare. Okay. Saving the deck and getting ready for round 1.